our special guest, Mr. Dr. Lahen Haddad, former Minister of Tourism and International Expert. He graduated from Indiana University in 1993 with a PhD in the humanities and social sciences. Dr. Haddad is also an international expert in strategic studies, democracy, governance, and development. His experience in Morocco and internationally has enabled him to develop a global integrated and strategic vision on economic and social development issues in Morocco and other developing countries. His intervention in projects and studies of national and international importance gives him a mastery of the issues of geostrategy, economic development, public policy, international relations, governance, tourism, and more. Doctor, welcome.
Thank you, Lucia. Thank you so much for giving me the floor to contribute these closing remarks to the forum. And excellent forum, by the way. Congratulations for mobilizing such an array of experts to talk about this promising topic, which is the nexus between artificial intelligence and climate change. Interesting exchanges, great ideas, excellent organization. So thank you so much for this great event. I guess the idea that motivates us all is the following. As climate change is the biggest challenge facing the planet, what if we use the potential of machine learning to bring solutions for climate action? A lot of discoveries, of course, remain to be found for us to truly understand what use we can make of it. But there are promising uses, there are discoveries, there are good practices, and the inroads are great, but of course a lot remains to be discovered and a lot remains to be harnessed. Science has progressed tremendously, and 4.0 and 5.0 industries helping, I am sure we can do a lot in the few coming years. What we need to remember is that artificial intelligence is not a silver bullet, but it could help a lot. I'm not an expert myself, but from what I read and I see, the use of artificial intelligence for dealing with climate issues is already a reality in so many ways. So take, for example, what SoftBank did when it developed the robot Pepper that is based on machine learning and which can interact with humans by reading their emotions and having conversation, throwing a ball. It's still, of course, weak artificial intelligence, but it's already in use in companies and schools. What we may wonder is like, how could we use technological breakthroughs like this to develop robots to prevent food waste, to integrate sustainable living in our daily lives? And I think what is promising is deep learning. And deep learning enables, like, for example, better predictions and estimates of climate change. You know, the research led by Sustainability Google, the Borealis Artificial Intelligence of the Mila Institute, the German Aerospace Center work, all of that demonstrated the critical role that artificial intelligence has in making sense of the extensive data set on Earth, understanding better climate change and acting upon it. And deep learning provides enhanced energy monitoring for buildings, for electric cars. It also leads to sufficient energy distribution and battery management, enabling reduced carbon footprint and switching to renewable energies. I know that researchers and scientists have determined different kinds of fields, such as energy consumption, CO2 removal, education, solar engineering, and finance as possible fields where machine learning can be developed. And the functions, of course, are enormous. It includes monitoring, for example, deforestation, creating new low-carbon materials, greener transportation. We understand, of course, that an artificial intelligence is still at its beginning and cannot solve everything, but the successes could be phenomenal in the future. And for example, like artificial intelligence can help us in understand better climate change. We can do global scale modeling, individual weather forecasting. And for example, when you do this kind of global scale modeling to individual weather forecasting, it relies on a massive number of variables. And those variables are impossible for a human brain to do on its own. Therefore, you need this, you need machine learning, you need artificial intelligence for that. The interpretation of climate data is based, of course, on what we call informatics, and it covers a lot of topics such as predicting extreme weather events, reconstructing past climate conditions, the socioeconomic impacts of climate change and precipitations, for example, in the Sahel region in Africa. And this can help policymakers take action, save lives, deal with this, do mitigation kind of policies, interventions. Artificial intelligence, for example, could predict the relationship between the measures that we take and how fast we will go to the 2 centigrade on the Celsius rising global temperature, which is what has been decided in Paris, I mean, like in COP20. It could, for example, based on satellite imaging, detect and map significant CO2 emitting sources in countries where the regulation about reporting is scarce, or probably those countries don't have the means to do that because they are poor countries. But for example, if you take electricity systems, they account for about like 1/4 of the global CO2 emissions. And Carbon Tracker, which is a great independent financial think tank working towards the UN goal of preventing new coal plants from being built by 2020, they could monitor coal plants emissions by using the satellite data and convince the finance industry that it's not profitable, that it's not sustainable, and it would not go there. Therefore, like pushing governments to use alternative means than coal plants. That's also a good thing. I mean, like that Carbon Tracker has done in the past. So, As Duran D'Souza, who is a data scientist and a Carbon Tracker data scientist, said, "In artificial intelligence can be used worldwide in places that are not monitoring, and we don't have to ask for permission." Very interesting. Like even like places where there is no permission, or we cannot go into, then artificial intelligence can give you that possibility to monitor and also to track the carbon emissions and all of that. Of course, there are all kinds of questions about ethics, there are questions about sovereignty and all of that are posed, but those are need to be dealt with like in a collective kind of manner. So these are only a few examples. There are a dozen other great uses, which makes it a promising field, great for climate and fundamental for the effort to save the planet. So, but of course there are challenges, and to see these challenges, I invite you to read the report of the United Nations Secretary General, Roadmap for Digital Cooperation, which was published only about 5 months ago in June 2020. And on artificial intelligence, the report says, while interest in artificial intelligence is very high, is overwhelmingly high, there is a gap in international coordination, collaboration and governance. That's where there is the need right now. And also there is a problem of representation and inclusiveness in global discussions. For example, there are 42 countries, developing countries, that are largely absent from or not well represented in most prominent forums on artificial intelligence, despite having a very significant opportunity to benefit from it for their economic and social development. The work done by UNESCO, for example, on the ethics of artificial intelligence is an example of the role that the UN is playing and can play to ensure this kind of inclusiveness, if you like. And the other challenge is like current artificial intelligence related initiatives, there is no coordination or lack coordination that makes it accessible to other countries outside the existing groups, the think tanks, United Nations entities, and other stakeholders. There are, for example, 160 organizational, national, and international ethics and governance principles worldwide, However, there is no common platform to bring these separate initiatives together. I'm still quoting the report by the UN Secretary General, which is a great report, by the way. And so to address these kinds of issues, what the Secretary General is proposing is having this kind of multi-stakeholder advisory body on global artificial intelligence cooperation. And that will provide like the guidance for international community. It's better governance. It's also something that is trustworthy, human rights based, and also to have something, I mean, like an AI that is safe, sustainable, and promotes peace. I would add probably to this recommendation, that's where we come, is climate change also needs to be added to this really great idea that comes from the UN. And this, of course, it's a good body that will serve as a diverse forum to share and promote best practices, exchange views on artificial intelligence standardization, compliance efforts, and taking into account existing mandates and institutions, and dealing with the questions of ethics and sovereignty that I talked about. So the great forum that you guys have organized these last 2 days should be part of this kind of concerted efforts. I could see it leading like thinking and science in this field in coordination with the COP and also with the United Nations effort. So with this, I end these closing remarks. Thank you again. Please stay safe and have a great day.